Looks good? Yeah. Alright, cool. First of all, talk about doing this modeling thing. Looks like you got it down. You haven't been doing it your whole life, but it looks like you have.
If I look like I have it down, then, you know, I'm faking it. So, no, I mean, I have fun. I'm real comfortable in front of the cameras. I'm not a shy person, so it's not difficult. And people always wonder if it's weird for me posing and, like, not very much material, but my workout outfit is my job, you know? Sure. Like, I go to the pool and I put my swimsuit on, and that's what I'm supposed to wear, so.
Right, talk about hooking up a Speedo, how that all kind of happened and enjoying that for you.
Yeah, well, hooking up a Speedo was extremely natural. I've been wearing Speedo since I was 4 years old, so it was just a natural thing for me to get involved and, you know, work with them more. And we're launching a new line called Accelerate, and that's what we're working on today. And it's like the everyday, you know, a mom can wear it to run her errands. You know, people don't want, we don't want to see it as just like, oh, you know, you have to be full-on fitness freaks to be wearing it. Everyone wears it. You know, I put it on when I'm running my errands, jogging around, walking my dogs, whatever.
Yeah, talk about that in terms of like, what is about this? Is it for the material? What is it about Speedo that makes it work for everyone and also be athletic?
Well, the thing about Speedo is they know how to make athletic wear, but then they also make stuff that's really cute, feminine, and fun, and great colors, and great fits. You know, it needs to be practical. You need to be able to wear it when you're wearing your, going your errands, but you want to look good.
Yeah.
You know, we're girls. We want to look good while we're doing it, but it's got to be practical as well. So they've done a great job of, you know, putting the two together, being practical and being cute.
Yeah. So. Talking about looking good, when did people start approaching you to do modeling? At one point in your career were people like trying to get you for their campaigns and magazines? When did that kind of start?
I guess it just kind of is a snowball effect. You know, once they see a couple of different print ads and stuff like that, photos, and kind of they want more and more and more. And so, I mean, it's great for me. I love it. So
yeah.
It's fun. I enjoy doing photo shoots. So the more photos I get out there, the more jobs I get, I guess. How it works.
And this last year with the Olympics and everything, talk about what's happened since. And normally, is there kind of a letdown after that? And you're just kind of like taking up some of that?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people talk about having like a full-on letdown after Olympics because you're at such a high, you know, you train your whole life for that moment,
yeah.
And then it's over. And I think, because I swam the 96 and 2004 Olympics,
yeah.
That I kind of know how to deal with it now. And in 96, I think I dealt with a little bit of the letdown, but then I learned from it. So I'm a little bit older and more experienced. So I didn't really feel a letdown after this one. I was working so much after it and having so much fun that I didn't even realize that the Olympics were over.
Right.
I'm still like on a high from it. So
yeah, you signed with Elite right after the Olympics?
Yeah, I signed with Elite Models. So I've been working with them for about 6 months now. So
what
it's been
good. What have you been doing? What's happened like? If you can put that in words.
It's interesting. It's
yeah.
Always fun. It's different because I don't classify myself as a model. I classify myself as an athlete.
Sure.
That, you know, I like doing modeling type gigs and stuff like that, you know. And it's fun. It's especially fun when I get to put on fitness wear. So
yeah.
That's always, you know, I'm at home and
right.
In my athletic wear.
Sure. Talk about kind of the celebrity that's kind of come with being an athlete and doing this kind of thing. Is it all the attention that comes your way? Have you enjoyed that? Has that changed over the years? Or?
Well, I don't really notice a celebrity type thing that doesn't, you know, like, and I hope that I never notice that kind of stuff because I need to focus on my training and my work and stuff like that. So I don't really let that stuff, you know, it's great when people approach me and say congratulations and stuff like that. I really appreciate that. And
yeah.
It keeps me motivated to keep going. But the whole celebrity thing isn't really in my field. So.
No. Do you bring the same kind of focus and discipline to a job like this that you do to swimming, or is this kind of fun when you look at it?
Well, I guess I bring my focus, you know, and energy, but I also like goof around a lot because
yeah.
I'm not allowed to goof around when I'm in the
sure.
pool. That's very, very serious. So, you know, when I'm having fun and it kind of shows through the pictures and stuff, I think that's always good.
Yeah. Talk about this line comes out in the summer?
This line is coming out in March. So it's, I mean, you can order it now. It's,
right.
You can go onto the Speedo website and order the products now, and you can get it, you know, actually really soon. I think the product's going to be coming out in the next week or two.
Wow.
Yeah.
So talk about all the young people, young women and men, they're looking at you and they're gonna
yeah.
see you doing this. They're going to want to go out and buy this stuff, I would think.
Yeah, I mean, it's great stuff for any age. It can
yeah.
be great for mothers or girls my age, and you know, and that's the thing that's great. They have colors, like they have whites, pinks, blues, you know, and then they have brighter colors for
right.
younger kids, and then the moms can wear the lighter pastel-y colors,
sure.
and it really branches out to everyone, yeah. So it's great.
Talk about staying in such amazing shape. Is that all swimming or is it non-stop working out? What do you do to stay in shape?
Well, I train a lot, so I try to eat as healthy as possible. When I'm on the road, it kind of makes it difficult, but I guess swimming 4 or 5 hours a day helps me stay in shape.
Sure.
So that works.
Are there certain things you can put in the world, like certain secrets, certain foods you always stay away from, or certain foods you always have to eat, or there's certain things that you can kind of...
I try to eat as much vegetables and fruits as possible, and I drink a lot of milk.
Yeah.
And tons and tons of water. I gotta stay hydrated or else I'm done.
Yeah.
And I just try to stay away from fast food. I don't like limit myself. I don't like, I'm not that strict on myself. I have ice cream and stuff like that, so.
Right.
You gotta live.
Sure. Any beauty products that you kind of live by, or certain things that kind of like, those are your things?
Sunscreen.
Yeah.
I train out in Tucson, so I pile on sunscreen. I wear zinc when I swim and stuff like that, so.
Right.
And good conditioners and, you know, the hair, so.
Sure.
Yeah.
Talk about being the new Sports Illustrated. What's that been like for you? What kind of response have you gotten?
I've gotten great positive response from the Sports Illustrated. My family really likes it, and I think the picture came out really nice,
yeah.
And it looks really natural, and yeah, I think it's pretty. I'm very honored. I think it's a big deal and stuff like that, so I'm real stoked on it.
Yeah. Are you familiar with this whole ESPN, they're voting you?
I know, I try not to pay attention to that, but everybody tells me, they're like, oh, you're on ESPN's hottest female. Okay. So yeah, that's great. That's flattering, but
right.
I'm not like going on and voting for myself or anything like that.
No.
So.
Not clicking on yourself.
No.
Do you have acting aspirations? Anything else you want to do in the?
I want to try everything.
Yeah.
You know, and see what I'm good at. And obviously, if I'm not good at it, then ditch it.
Right.
But I did a sitcom, Quintuplets.
Sure.
That aired back in November.
Uh-huh.
So that was fun. It was just a great experience. I did it with Jason Priestley, and
yeah.
it was really awesome. I wouldn't mind doing more stuff like that, because I think I just had a lot of fun with it.
Right,
so,
right.
Definitely.
And you get to hang out with your male counterpart in the Soul Speedo thing, Michael Phelps. You guys get to
and Michael hang out every now and then. I like checking out his photos, see what he does.
Yeah.
So that's always interesting. But he's busy in college now, and I'm, you know, busy in college too. So
sure.
You don't get much time to actually run into each other besides swim meets.
Right. And when's the next big competition for you?
My next big swim meet's in April.
Yeah.
So we have our world championship trials. So hopefully I'll be swimming with champs this summer in Montreal.
Very good.
Yeah.
All right, Amanda.
Thank you.
Pleasure talking to you.
Eyebrow dark, one light.
You want to do
makeup? No, I don't wear makeup.